Here's Beefcake proving he can do it all. Isn't it nice he gets Amir out and at least shows the victim?
Oh, he's just trying to rub it in. Someday somebody's going to put him in a whole room full of mirrors, and you're going to see how badly his face is going to be smashed up. You know, if he ever messed with any members of my family.
With some of the guys in your family, he doesn't need any of that extracurricular stuff. He just needs the mirror. Take a look at the kisser, and that's enough to shock anybody.
How about ravishing Rick Rude? How about the body on him?
Well, he'll get a chance, ravishing Rick Rude, to prove just how good his body is, because coming up December 19th from Caesars in Atlantic City, the Slammies presentations. And one of the categories, Brain, is the best body, I understand.
You mean there's other people in the category with him? They're wasting their time on
Mr. Wonderful will be there.
Oh, come on.
You know, the go-around between he and ravishing Rick Rude, we haven't come to an end of that yet.
And you won't until Wonderful makes his mind up to quit the sport of professional wrestling. Maybe you could work around here parking cars out front.
Maybe not. Put that date down in your book, December 19th, Slammies Awards presentation, Caesars in Atlantic City. We'll be right back after this.
Scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring at this time, from Samoa, weighing 300 pounds, Sika. His opponent is from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing 248 pounds. Here comes Jake the Snake Roberts.
Oh, this is the ovation for Jake the Snake Roberts, along with Damien, as he makes his way down the ramp here in Toronto. Sort of slithering in, Nick.
You said it, not me.
I guess so. I did say that, yes. Kind of sorry I said that.
Why didn't you add slither and slime?
Huh? No, I didn't say that.
You didn't say that, right. I'm tremendously curious. Are they cheering Jake the Snake Roberts? Are they cheering the reptile?
Damien? Oh, Damien gets his share.
Oh, I'm sure. There's no question about it. I mean, I question, you know, people have makeup. People pick the clothes they wear to make them look nice. What is Snake's problem that he must have such an identity crisis that he's got to haul around a boa constrictor with him?
Well, obviously he likes reptiles.
Undoubtedly.
Yeah. Like a family member, I understand.
Well, they say pick your friends, I guess, you know.
You hear the chant, DDT. Unfortunately, Sika hears it as well. They announced him at 300 pounds. I believe he's closer to that 350-pound mark. He's a monster.
He's a big man. Again, one of the natural, powerful men. They don't have the most symmetrical bodies, but then they are the ones who are natural strength. Yes.
Former co-holder of the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. Kind of wasted time to be hitting Sika in the head as well.
That's kind of the feeling I get. That'd be like trying to judo chop a coconut open with your hand.
Going to an arm wringer here. First thing, I don't know, for my money, I'd want to take this guy off his feet as quickly as I could.
This is the thing, of course, needless to say, that the Snake, if he's going to have any intelligence, should do. Big, powerful men basically can only use their power when standing. You get them down on the mat, it is the exception rather than the rule that
equalizes all that power. If you want to stand there and trade blows with Sika, you'll end up with a short end of the stick in a hurry. Oh, what a shot that was. Front face lock by the big guy. He can wear you down with this one. Front face lock, been around for a long time, Nick Barkley.
Most of the wrestling holds come from ancient times. I'm sure if we could go back beyond ancient times, we'll find it in the caves of our atavistic predecessors.
Look at the kisser.
I'm not quite sure his mother would appreciate that crap.
Well, try to call it as I see it here. Leaves a lot to be desired.
You being authority on kissers, then.
Well, yes. If I see one that looks kind of straight, look at that one.
Catch a mirror.
Holding on to this front face lock for dear life. Roberts trying to come out of there. Easier said than done. It's so hard for a referee to judge whether this is in fact a chokehold or not as well.
Yes, it's only the movement of a half inch, and I'm sure that Sika wouldn't choke him.
Oh, of course. Of course.
express you being so friendly with all those Polynesian people.
I express his magnanimity to all of the wrestlers. The thing about the face lock right here, what's so very simple, is that it's the forearm, the bone on the forearm, which catches under the chin. And this is what kind of locks it in. A lot of people say, well, it looks like you get your head right out of there. But once that forearm bone on the lower arm, now, of course, he's going for a reverse headlock at the same time. And this could possibly equalize it if he gets him over a little further.
He's working on it. He's jerking away. But the power of Sika just was too much.
He has the advantage because he's already got Snake's head turned. It's amazing that Snake's head can't do as well as Damien's head when it turns.
I imagine it takes quite a bit of time as well to have that particular kind of hairstyle. Because that's not natural, is it? It takes time to do that to Sika.
Being someone who really can't even discuss hairstyles,
are you talking about you or me?
You.
Yeah. Well, I know where my strength lies in that field, but I was just questioning.
That looks rather a la natural.
A la natural. Okay. You've been so up on all these Polynesian groups. You spend a lot of time over there in the Hawaiian Islands.
Yes, I have.
Well, there certainly are a lot of Samoans there, are there not?
Yes, there are. Tremendous. The entire Samoan nationality, from an athletic point of view, are great athletes, and they breed some pretty strong, hefty stock, as you're looking at when you look at Sika right here.
If Jake the Snake doesn't come out of here in a hurry, this thing is going to be over.
Undoubtedly, he has got the effect of half a sleeper, in the sense that one of the jugular veins on this one side, the blood must be being cut off of the brain to some extent. Both of them, the blood being cut off to both causes the sleeper to have effect of this, but he's still hanging in there.
In other words, you're saying that he pinched off one of the carotid arteries.
Absolutely.
As we look right over the ominous green bag that contains Damien, Jake the Snake Roberts has, in fact, come out of this. Whoa. Only temporarily, I'm afraid.
Well, we want to think that for all of the assistance that Damien has given, he could haul him around in something better than a green duffel bag.
Well, what would you like to see out there?
Oh, something a little bit of velvet.
With class.
Sure, absolutely. Actually, how about a reptile skin bag? Damien brings his own.
Well,
just wait for the next season and we'll do it.
Wait for the next shedding.
Yes.
Chokehold right in front of the referee.
Ah, but within the four count.
Five, yes.
Four, it's okay.
Five, you're in trouble. Or however the referee sees fit. It's really a judgment call. Right?
It is, but I mean, basically, 4 seconds, you can do as you wish. Then you must break by four. Five, you're disqualified.
Well, there are some exceptions to that, Nick Bockwinkel. There are times when you do things inside that ring that the referee can call an automatic disqualification without any count at all.
That's true, but it seems like the rules are getting more lenient and more lenient all the time. I think there should be more structured rulings.
In other words, during your heyday inside the squared circle, you say the rules were more stringent.
I did a superb job of working within the rules.
I know you did. You did a superb job of breaking quite a few of them as well.
Bending would be a better phrase.
Bending. Jake the Snake Roberts is still having trouble here, as the big Samoan has now gone to the trapezius area.
On both sides. On both sides.
Oh, he's around front now. He had to turn it loose, but managed to hold on to it.
Far more advantageous position before when he was in the back.
No question.
Behind him.
Oh, got stomped on. Stomped on the big toe. I don't care how big you are, that hurts.
Real classic wrestling move.
Well, hey, you do whatever you have to do when you're inside there. Especially if you're in trouble and you got a 340-pounder pounding away at you.
And that is what he is doing. Fine fashion, too.
Really doing a nice job of disassembling Jake the Snake Roberts. Irish whip coming up. Hard into the corner. Followed right in, but a little bit too late. Oh, scooped him right underneath. He got a three count. It appeared that one shoulder may have been up there.
That's what I'm calling.
We'll have to take a closer look here on the replay. Asika just dropped him like a bad habit from behind after the count went down.
I'm sorry, I'd have to disagree with that one.
Uh-oh, Roberts has opened the bag. He got Paul Harvard, and there, oh! Asika was about to go after Damien. I'm sure he's seen a lot of those.
I would presume this is a controlled environment, but anytime somebody comes out with a 12 or 14 foot long boa constrictor, it doesn't really turn my spirits on.
Well, Asika just took one look at Damien and didn't really back up. Let's go back and take a look and see if the shoulders, in fact, were down or not. Here it comes. Charge right in, nobody home. He dropped down right in front of him. Hooks him now with a nice underhook. Shoulders are down now. No, there's one up.
Come on, see?
There's one came up on the two count.
Now, the referee seemed to turn his head to the left as though he was looking at the other shoulder. But, I mean, his vision, it had to be within the peril, you know, within the side of his vision. The scope
of his regardless vision of what I say or Nick Bockwinkel says, that man right there gets the victory. We'll be back.
Jake the Snake Roberts hasn't lost a thing. He's certainly a dominant feature here in the WWF. Let me ask you this.
Yes.
Miss Betty, she's still out at the ranch?
The ranch?
Yeah.
What do you mean, the ranch?
You know the ranch, the one I'm talking about.
No, Miss Betty is on the tennis courts right now.
Oh, excuse me, on the tennis courts.
Giving
lessons, I'm sure. Plenty of more action still to come here this week on Primetime Wrestling, direct from Caesar's Palace here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Right now, we're going to take you to Mean Gene Okerlund.
What are you guys doing? Put me down. I'm gonna fall.
Wow, that pile driver video is doing just tremendous. In fact, right now it's even on active rotation on MTV. What is it? Oh, you do have some pull
when
here.
When you go with me, you go with first class.
Oh, terrific. I love it.
You're checking.
I'll get you later. I'll get you later.
What, you stiffing the guy again?
Stiffing the guy. I'm right on tab
here. Give me a break, Frank.
Stiff the guy later.
You stiffed the guy last night.
An extra little, a few dollars on it for you, pal. You know, the big one.
Give me a break. Let's talk, Brain, about Slammy's presentation. Coming up December 19th from Caesars in Atlantic City. What kind of pull you got down there?
Caesars?
Yeah, Caesars.
Red carpet treatment.
Red carpet treatment.
I come in that place, they even close the boardwalk.
I understand that you're up for several categories.
Yes, I am. Manager of the year. I've got to win that one.
Well, that's debatable.
Television announcer?
Commentator of the year?
Hands down.
Hands down. You better keep your hands down. Better keep your hands in your pockets. I understand, does anyone at home know what kind of money you're losing out here? That $3 you blew last night?
Blew $3 last night.
Well, I understand that you did.
I'm just warming up.
You're warming up.
Oh, I got it. I can feel it.
You can feel it. Well, maybe you'll get lucky in Caesars at Atlantic City December 19th, because that's where the big Slammy's presentation will be coming from. But right now, we're here. What is
it? I ordered umbrellas.
You ordered umbrellas.
I can't drink these without umbrellas.
What do you can't drink an umbrella?
Joel.
Give me a break. We're right here in Las Vegas, Nevada, at Caesars Palace, but next month, December 19th, we'll be at Caesars in Atlantic City for the big Slammy's presentation. We'll be back in just a moment.
He's fired.
Everything.
Ask Duggan if you don't believe me.
Ask Duggan.
Tough guy.
Got your hands full here this week, Brain, with the Junkyard Dog.
I got my hand full right now with the
I want you to lay off this stuff because, you
just
know,
punch.
It's not good for your health, Brain.
Just punch.
And you're in bad enough health as it is.
What do you mean?
Right now, let's go to ringside for our feature matchup.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Kansas City, weighing 255 pounds, King Harley Race.
It means only one thing. The King is on his way down to the ring here. We'll soon be approaching the ramp here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. I'm Gorilla Monsoon, being joined here at the broadcast position by Nick Bockwinkel, wrestler extraordinaire, a man whose name is synonymous with the word professional wrestling.
A pleasure being here, Gino.
Well, it's a pleasure to have you.
Thank you, sir.
Uh-oh, we're going to be joined here by the King, yes? Yes, King, what is it?
His opponent is from Charlotte, North Carolina. Weighing 280 pounds, here comes the Junkyard Dog.
Well, the Junkyard Dog, the JYD, making his way down here. Of course, I'm
May I ask a question?
Yes.
Family secret?
No, he was just apologizing. The King was apologizing for not having his cape and crown. We all know where that is. Well, maybe we don't all know where that is.
Well, I've been told.
That's Jim Duggan has possession of those two particular items at this point in time. I don't know why he's apologizing. I never... Well, actually, the cape was stolen out of the Beacon Theater props department.
Actually, I think he ought to just stand up on the microphone and tell...
Tell everyone.
The entire world what has taken place, because I think it's a smidgen disgraceful. Duggan, somebody that, as far as I'm concerned, with his 2x4, the way he carries on, you look at him and you know they just let him out on weekends.
Well, it's got to be a little humiliating for the King to have to come out here without his cape and his crown, because he's really become attached to it.
I'm sure he has.
Junkyard Dog, and both he and the King have made some very derogatory statements about one another. Whoa, nice block, a double block. Whoa. I don't think the King is going to fare too well if he wants to mix it up in that respect with the Junkyard Dog, Nick.
Yes, I would imagine that the cranium of the dog is something that you could probably pound on all day and all night. And
he resembles that remark.
I'm sure he does.
Side headlock by the dog in a very unorthodox position here. King is trying to turn him around here. He doesn't want to stay in this too long.
Listen to the dog. He's going. Once he leaves the dressing room, he starts talking. He doesn't stop till the match is over. And maybe not even then.
Maybe they should team him and Matilda up, you know, a couple of dogs.
Uh-huh.
They both look just as bad.
Being very derogatory.
Rightfully so, I imagine.
Irish whip in, drop down, dog quickly over the top. Oh, look at this, 360 by the King. He's suspended in midair. There he goes. Luckily, he landed on his feet.
Very, very fortuitously for him. If he'd have hit that apron, he could have, you know, busted it.
Both ways.
Yes, spleen, anything. His thighs, both knees.
I can remember several years ago when I fell off an apron in Honolulu, Hawaii.
Yeah.
With someone who's very close to me physically at this particular point in time involved.
Was it Galileo that worked with gravity?
About heavier
things going down faster?
It was Newton.
Newton, was it?
Yeah. Oh, look at that. I love it.
I'd have to say there's a couple of hard hits.
Both of them just staring at each other. Whoa, the King come up with the short end of the stick on that one. Caught that one right on a cheekbone. Look at the King. He doesn't have a clue where he is. Dog over for the cover. Not going to get him.
No, not that casually. You want to cover the man, cover him. You possibly tell me what the word thump on the back posterior of the dog, what significance it has.
What is the word?
Is it thump?
Thump, yes.
Yes, what is it? Is that, tells him what he's doing when he sits down, or
well,
the way it hits?
Well, it's a phrase that connotates what the dog does to his opponents. He thumps him.
He thumps him.
He thumps him.
Is that his thumper?
I would assume.
I see.
Did you ever have anything written on your tights?
Never needed it.
Oh, I didn't think so.
Usually victory someplace.
Victory. Whoa, got him again. Oh, right in the nose.
The King in a whole lot of trouble in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens as the Junkyard Dog really doing a number on him. And Bobby DeBrain Heenan in a lot of trouble here at Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada. I understand that you dumped another $2. We'll be back with a continuation of this match in a moment.
Not that way.
Troubles, turn on your hotspot. Time to whirl all your woes away.
The new Pollinex Whirlpool Hotspot.
Listen, Brain, security called me earlier this morning. You gave Red Skelton a hard time last night.
No, I didn't. I was walking through the lobby. He came up to me. He wanted autographs, wanted pictures, wanted to talk about Andre the Giant.
You were following the guy around and pestering him.
I was.
People here at Caesar's Palace don't like that.
What do you think? I just checked in here, walking around, bother everybody like out of town or like a hick?
That's your usual modus operandi. Right now, we're going to go back to ringside, Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens, see how the King's doing.
Hey, there's Cher.
Well, the dog has won the headbutt battle so far.
Right in the pocket, baby. Got him in the pocket.
Oh, I thought he might have been going for a pile driver there. Chose not to. Oh, the King is upside down again. He's having trouble just finding his way around inside that squared circle. He's hanging there upside down. He's about to come down in our lap here.
Just about. We could possibly have a third commentator at ringside.
I'm surprised that Bobby the Brain Heenan is not in attendance. Although, as you say, you never know where the brain is.
That's true. He could be in the building somewhere.
Another one sends him back into the steel barricade. As you can see, he's very close to our broadcast position.
Do we have to give any credit to the dog for because he uses his head that consequently he's intelligent?
Not necessarily.
I hope you'd say that.
No. But I believe that at this particular point in time, he's fighting fire with fire. Uh-oh, got caught. Dragged out. They're both on the floor now out here by us. And whoa, what is going on? Oh, Ram, right. He rang the bell. He used the King to ring the bell. King could well be out of this.
That rang as well as the timekeeper's hammer.
Boy, he did it all right there. Referee laying the count on now. I'll be very surprised if the king gets back in. Can't believe he's not busted wide open. Maybe he is. He's still got his back to us. He's back there up on the apron. He's not. And he does a 360 back kick. King is certainly having his problems, Nick.
There's no question about it. I have to agree with you.
I think that maybe the brain not being in attendance is having some kind of an effect on it. But, of course, this one a long way from being over.
You have to understand something. The King was a fantastic wrestler. Traveled the world with a tremendous reputation before he and Bobby Heenan put it together, which at that time only made the two of them an even more dynamic package.
Well, I'm sure that your record and his record, as far as matches are concerned, would probably parallel each other.
I would think so, yes.
Neck breaker coming up. Nailed him with it. Not going to beat him that way, dog. Two contrasting styles here.
Dog is going to have to pick up and make over a faster tempo in order to beat the King than this. Just trying to out-headbutt him, out-punch him, hopefully trying to outpower him. That won't do it. Dog's gone through, he's been too many times down the bottom of the pit of hell and back to lose in that fashion.
Well, I think the longer this match goes, the more in favor of Harley it's going to be. Oh, look at that.
Oh.
Belly to belly, suplex.
Suplex.
Nailed him with it. That'll knock the wind out of you in a hurry. Sort of a pyramid cover there by the King. Sort of a tripod-ish type.
Actually a great, great Greco-Roman move.
Yes, no question.
Executed with
a lot of finesse.
Yes, and deliberateness. Right on the money.
Pendulum has swung the other way now in this match. Whoa. You don't want to trade right hands with a dog. That's not the way to beat him. Oh, look at that one. Harley on Dream Street again. Looking for somewhere to go, somewhere to hide. Stuck a finger in the eye, that didn't even stop him. Side headlock as the dog gets shot in. They sort of hit nose to nose there. The referee went down as well.
They're down on that. Referees have got to be on their toes. And that's not being facetious in this point. You can't, you want to stay close to the action, but you can't get too close because bodies are flying at a pretty fair speed.
Oh, look at this. And fell down on top of the referee, too. Tripped over the backup, and the dog gets counted out.
One can call it the old schoolboy. The old schoolboy finished, but that's exactly what it was.
Well, he ended up tripping right over the referee who was laying face down on the canvas. Let's get the official word.
The winner of this match, King Harley Race.
King declared the winner, but I'm not sure he realizes that he's a winner, Nick.
No, undoubtedly not. He's been pounded pretty good. I think ever from the moment that his head hit the big brass ringside bell, it's been another ball game.
Harley helping the referee up here. The dog questioning the referee, saying, I won. No, Harley saying he won. And the referee does raise Harley's hand. Let's go back and take a look at what went down here earlier on. Referee got clotheslined.
Good.
Got an elbow from the dog on the way down. And the dog wasn't too much the worse for wear here.
He tried to get the referee back up, but to no avail, just slightly ever so much. Dog undoubtedly did not have good balance to begin with. There's no question
he
about
was
it.
Hurt,
he was falling
more than
backwards. He was falling backwards. So as far as I'm concerned, I have to give full credit to Harley Race.
It's going to go down in the record books as a win for the King. We'll be back.
Well, the King slid by again.
He still won the match.
I noticed you weren't there.
I was up in the booth.
You were up in the booth.
I always observe. You don't see me at ringside.
I'm in the building. I'm someplace.
Well, why do you always complaining then when someone else is there doing the broadcast with me if you're in the building?
Because I have to watch my own back.
I understand that the King is up for an award in the Slammy's presentation coming down December 19th out of Caesars in Atlantic City.
Most attractive ring attire, I believe that's the category.
All that stuff that he stole from the Beacon Theater.
He didn't steal nothing. That's handmade by Patsy and Victor for him.
I understand that when Duggan got his hands on that stuff, he cleaned everything up, had it dry cleaned and everything.
Dry cleaned. Probably
so the King was dragging it around everywhere.
He was not. You can't believe Duggan. He's a cockeyed liar.
We're certainly having a great time here at Caesars Palace in lovely Las Vegas, Nevada. We'll be back as we take a look right now at where the World Wrestling Federation will be appearing. Well, folks, that wraps it up for another week here on Primetime Wrestling. What a lovely time we've had out here in Las Vegas, Nevada, the guests of Caesars Palace, and what a job they did for us, Brain.
I think next week we might go to Maui.
We might not. There are too many exotic drinks in Maui to suit you.
You're
putting on a lot of weight lately.
I'm not.
Yes, you are.
The best I've ever felt.
Well, don't forget, folks, we're in Las Vegas, Nevada right now at Caesars Palace, but December 19th. In fact, we will be at Caesars in Atlantic City for an outstanding performance of the Slammy's Awards presentation. It is going to be a happening, Brain. I know you're going to be there. I'll be there. I expect that almost everyone that has a television set will be able to view that event. So until next time, Gorilla Monsoon for Bobby the Brain Heenan saying so long from Caesars Palace here in Las Vegas, Nevada.
WWF Primetime Wrestling returns next Thursday at 9. And for more great grappling, catch Mean Gene in WWF All-American Wrestling Sunday at noon. Now, stay tuned for Airwolf next on USA.